Welcome to the City of Kearney Information Break, a short interview series to highlight projects, issues, and events in the community. My name is Suzanne, and today we're talking with Stormwater Program Manager Andy Harder. Thank you for joining us today, Andy.
Thank you.
Now, the Stormwater Program affects everyone in the community. Can you tell us a little bit about the purpose of it?
Basically, the purpose of our program is to meet regulations set forth by the EPA and DEQ. The city's main focus is to establish a program that helps us reduce the amount of pollutants that we're putting into our local streams and rivers. We do that through a lot of different ways. One of our main focuses is the construction runoff programs. But more than that, we also focus on community education, involvement with the schools, illicit discharge detection, areas that we may not be aware that pollution's entering in through our systems. So there's a lot of elements to the program, but our main focus, especially now, is with the construction community and industrial community.
Now, how exactly can construction activities pollute our waters?
Most of the time, people think of the sediment runoff issues that we have with erosion. Basically, that's the one you see the most because of all the controls that are in place, silt fence, construction entrances, that sort of thing. But we also try to focus on the actual chemical pollutants that can be discharged during the rain events. So we like to implement a lot of controls like double containment, places for the concrete trucks to wash out, that sort of thing. So it's more than just the erosion control issues, it's also the chemical control issues.
Now, you also mentioned community habits. Are there things that shouldn't be put in a stormwater inlet?
Well, essentially that's pretty easy to answer because the only thing that should be allowed in the inlet is the rainwater. A lot of people don't understand that anything that goes into the storm sewer is considered a pollutant. And that even goes as far as your grass from your mowing, your leaves, which is the hard one to keep out of there, from the trees falling, but anything from pet waste, you got to realize that a lot of these things will mitigate through the rainwater into the storm sewer. So essentially, only allow the storm water to go down there.
Now, how can we prevent stormwater pollution? You talked about a few of those things that are kind of naturally occurring. How do we keep all of that from getting in there?
One good thing to focus on as far as a residential homeowner is things like your lawn care practices, the amount of fertilizers you're putting down. You know, be really mindful of the quantities you're putting down, because anything extra is just going to mitigate down the storm sewer and into the lakes and rivers and streams. And then litter prevention, keeping your cars maintained so the oils and fuels are not leaking onto the ground, because anything that's on the ground will wash down there.
Okay. Now, how can we report stormwater issues if, you know, we see things going into the stormwater inlet that shouldn't be, or we see a construction site that maybe looks like it needs some more issues handled?
There's a few ways you can report that sort of thing. You can either call my office or you can do that through the City of Kearney's website and report it there. And then we'll go out and address the issues as best we can. So,
now, of course, as a contractor, you know, I would want to make sure that my site is meeting all the standards that I have, and then I'm not adding any pollution to the stormwater system. So if I'm looking to do construction, whether it's at my home or a large project, how do I ensure that I'm going to meet those requirements?
Basically, with our construction program, there's two different elements with it. Larger construction projects are permitted through the state. The city does take care of implementing that program, so that's done through the Public Works Department. If you're over an acre of land, you will get permitted through the state, then the city reviews all of that and helps you along with that. As far as a residential build or a smaller construction project, that's done through our Development Services Department. You'll run into that when you get permitting and that sort of thing. And we try to provide the smaller builders with all the information that they need. It's quite a substantial program and there's a lot involved. So we've tried to provide them with as much information as they can. So basically they've got to make the decision on what type of controls to use, but everything else is provided for them. And we help them out with that. So.
Sounds good. Well, thank you, Andy. Now, if you have any questions about our stormwater program management or stormwater in general, you can call the city at 233-3273 or visit our website at cityofkearney.org. Thank you for watching. If you have any suggestions for issues or projects that you'd like to see featured here, you can email them to cityofkearney@kearneygov.org.